Italian.
Paul Head of England gets the silver medal. Jackson got the good start this time, didn't he? And he's away at the moment. Van der Kuip hitting hurdles and Jarrett coming through and the two Britons coming through. And this is a superb demonstration of high hurdling by Colin Jackson. He's the Commonwealth champion. Jarrett gets the silver.
It was wonderful to actually be running around in the red vest of Wales for a change and carrying the dragon. It's fantastic.
Christie got away very well. It's Christie all the way. Green of Jamaica second. And Christie's going right away from the whole field. Christie wins it by over a metre. And the time, 9.91. Only Leroy Burrell, the new world record holder, has run faster this season. Ladejo, totally focused. Ladejo's kicked it in. Green in second place. Right on the outside, Gitonga, the Kenyan. And Ladejo's got a battle here. It's Gitonga. Gitonga on the near side. And Gitonga's got to hold it. Gitonga wins. Ladejo in second place. Sunday Bada third. Just the javelin and the 800 metres to go. And this is Denise Lewis of England, lying in third place overall.
I couldn't believe the javelin at first, you know. I was expecting it to land and it kept going and going. So when that landed at 53 metres, I was, wow, gold is in sight. I had to run a PB to even get close to the medal, and I managed to do it, so I'm really chuffed, really, really chuffed. I had to keep telling myself, come on, Denise, keep Jane Fleming in sight, because you know you can do it if you just keep close to her. And I did.
I think the question now is, what tactics is Yvonne Murray going to use? How early is she going to go? If she leaves it to the last 100 metres, I think Alana Meyer could match her. I just hope Yvonne times it right. And when she goes for real. And there it is, 500 metres to go, and Yvonne Murray goes after the gold medal.
Murray can enjoy this. Her first major 10,000 metres. And she wins the Commonwealth title. A gold for Scotland. And here goes Denmark at last. He's got clear, and the race is really on. And it's Denmark with a decisive strike. Henrik coming fast though from Zimbabwe, but not quick enough. Denmark takes gold for England. Henrik the silver, not all. Takes the bronze for England.
Just a minute with 100 to go. I knew I'd got it. That sounds cocky, but I knew that no one was going to outsprint me. I was just too close to them. But it was bloody hard coming down that last 100. The crowd was all around me, just booming, and I just kept focusing and focusing.
A bit of history being made here. Judith Oakes attending the Commonwealth Games for the fifth time and attempting to win a title. She first won back in 1982. 18 metres 16. She moves further ahead in the gold medal position. Well, Reed has certainly got away well. I was watching him carefully. He's already up on Coyote, and Frankie Fredericks has him in his sights at the moment. And Effion going well from lane three. And it's Regis and Fredericks into the straight. And on the outside, Williams going well. But here comes Fredericks. Fredericks of Namibia powering it on now. And he's going to take gold from Don Regis, the silver, and Effion, the bronze. 19.96. And that's a brilliant, brilliant run. Adams from Holding, from Wiggins, these three. They're away from the rest of the field at the moment. And here comes Adams in front of his home crowd, and no way through for Holding yet. And Wiggins in third place. Adams is coming through and Holding challenging, but Adams wins it. Holding gets the silver.
That's better, yes! That's the sort of jump we've come to expect from Steve Smith.
So.
Away this time. Farquharson got a very good start, and so is Michelle Freeman in lane three. Freeman leading Farquharson in second place, and here comes Agyipong on the near side. Freeman and Agyipong, these two. Freeman takes the gold, Agyipong the silver, and Farquharson gets the bronze. A silver and bronze for England, 13.12 the time. Good championship win by Freeman, and medals for the two English women. There's 14 competitors in this final when they came out this morning, and just six left. Unfortunately, we've lost Andy Ashurst and Mike Edwards of England. But here goes Winter, first attempt. Oh, that's a very good one. And in fact, that is a new games record.
At 5.20, I'm always very nervous on my opening height, and couldn't find my pole. One of the Australians put it in their bag accidentally. And I was going around the pole vault area, you know, threatened because I couldn't find my pole. But luckily I got my pole and vaulted 5.20 first time. That gave me a lot of confidence.
On, and Holmes has gone out from about 300 plus, and she set herself up as the target, and Paula Schnur in second place putting real pressure on the Holmes, Schnur and Pels, 200 meters to go, and Holmes is now beginning to open up a gap, and Holmes, Kelly Holmes from the Middlesex Ladies Club and Army, really stretching them now into the straight, and the margin extending now. She's so strong, so fast in the final stages. And she's hurting now, but she's done enough. And Kelly Holmes of England is coming home to take the Commonwealth title. Paula Schnur takes the silver.
Needed that for an extra breakthrough. I had a quite good run at the Europeans. I mean, slow race, but I was pleased with silver medal, and I really wanted the gold this time.
So, Backley wants something a little extra here. I think he's really hit this one. Now that one seems to be flying much better. It's way over on the far side of the stadium, very close to going outside of the sector. 82 meters 74, England still in first, second, but the places have been reversed. It'll be interesting to see how Mickey Hill can respond.
This is his last throw. He's really hit that one long and hard. It's dipping a bit and comes down at about 79.50, probably a little less than that. So that's no improvement for Mick.
Gold medals. Thames Valley Harriers now have two gold medals in this Commonwealth Games. First it was Linford Christie, now for the men's triple jump. Young Julian Golly with a lifetime best performance when it most mattered. Matt Simpson now in round five. A little unsteady at the back of the circle, but he gets across it very well indeed. And Simpson getting better and better as this competition goes on. It's extended his lead once again.
Jamaican tying up a little. That's Laird. He'll hand over to Garth Robinson. Robinson has it. Growing the Dejo, has the baton in third place at the moment. And Ian Morris in from the Welsh have gone down, and that's very disappointing. They did promise so much. Ian Thomas has gone through. So, Jamaica, Trinidad Tobago, England, Australia going well now in fourth place. Dwayne Ladejo looking to take over the silver medal position at the moment, but the Jamaican's running hard. Garth Robinson, the Jamaican 200-meter champion. Can he hang on? For Trinidad and Tobago, Ian Morris. And Dwayne Ladejo coming very strongly on the outside. And the European champion, and Ladejo, can he take them all? And Ladejo!
by the young man who promised to take gold in the individual event and then got the silver behind Jitonga of Kenya. And he came through with a last leg of 44.2 seconds.
Linda Keogh fighting back on the last leg. The individual gold medalist, Kathy Freeman, against the gold medalist in the hurdles, Sally Gunnell. And Keogh fights back to give Gunnell a slight lead. Would it be enough? Gunnell on the last leg. Australia in second place. Nigerians made a fumble there. The Jamaicans in third place. So it's Gunnell against Kathy Freeman. And the Jamaican is Sandy Richards. Bronze medalist in the World Championship, bronze medalist in the 400 here. Nigerian is Yusuf, silver medalist in the 400 metres. This promised to be one of the races of the Games, and it has developed that way. Gunnell there to be shot at. Freeman boxed. Oh, is she cut across Yusuf? There may be a disqualification there. And Gunnell strikes for home, but Freeman comes through, and Gunnell fights back. But Freeman, for Australia, her third gold medal of the Games, a new Games record, but will it stand?
Luckily, I was out of trouble. I couldn't feel them on my shoulder, but I was just sort of waiting. I knew that they were three top-class 400 runners behind me, and I was just sort of hanging on as much as possible. But I think the incident comes out now. This is Kathy on the inside, and she obviously feels a bit trapped in there and decides to come out, but in doing so, she interferes with a Nigerian girl. Yep, definitely, you can see that.
So the Australians were disqualified and we moved up to gold. As a result of the delay, there was no medal ceremony for either the men's relay team or the women's in the stadium. Especially sad for those athletes who missed their first chance of being on the rostrum.